Hello and welcome back to another video. Hold on, let me put you down somewhere because this camera is so heavy. Oh my god, like I can't even. Gyms are closed, so I suppose this is my arm workout, so I should just be happy about it. But anyway. Little olive. First, I would like to address the elephant in the room. I basically had a really big spot and I've had to put a spot sticker on it. That's the white thing here. It was massive.
That's what she said.
This spot sticker like lets it heal, so you can't like take it off until it's like healed. And to be honest, it's better to look at this than to look at the spot, isn't it? So we're just gonna deal with this white patch on my face, because 2021, guys, is the year of keeping it real. You know, I have a white patch on my face. And I'm filming this video. And just like that, my camera stops recording me for some reason. And I still have the audio because I recorded that externally, but I have no idea what happened. I literally just droned onto the camera for ages before I even realized that it stopped recording. No clue. So you can listen to me drone on to the beautiful scenes of this beach and with some relaxing music as I just tell you a bunch of crap. A few things have changed. I have been moving from pillar to post. We found our place, we've moved into our place, absolutely loving it so far. But of course, COVID is still going on, so we are working from home. The office is obviously taking it very seriously. I don't know why it does that, it just stops recording after a little bit. But basically, in today's video, as always, we're gonna have a key topic to discuss throughout the video. And I want to talk about how you can up your social media marketing game. I'm gonna talk you through five ways you can use animations in five different types of videos and why each platform for these videos is so important. Let's go do that. Okay, first let's talk Instagram. We all use it, and if you're not one of the billion users, then you need to get onto it because it's one of the best, most cost-effective ways to market your brand, your service, whatever it may be. You can grow organically by pushing engagement and having real engagements with users, or you can go down the route of paying to market your content, basically doing ads. But that is a topic for another video. Organic growth is important for both new businesses and well-established companies. Pushing real organic engagement helps with your rankings in the Instagram algorithm, which can lead to sales, lead to new customers, new clients. So it's important all around, really. Within Instagram, stories is actually one of the most viewed areas on someone's profile. So more people are opting to watch stories than looking at feed posts. It's just easy. People go on and they just flick through some stories as opposed to scrolling through the whole feed. So it's really important for you to be getting content on there for people who are going to be missing out on all this amazing content you're making on your feed. You need to have things on your story too for all those story scammers so that they can see what you're trying to share as well. I actually have a template of the week episode all about this, which I will leave in the description box, a link to it down below, which you can check out. Drilling again, banging. Oh, he's banging. Oh, it's actually soaring. Soaring. Basically, what do you think is more likely to grab the attention of those mindless story scrollers? A story that just has a bunch of text in it, or a professional looking animation like this? I think we both know the answer to this one. So I just have a few work bits to get done for today. I have this video to film. I have two template of the weeks to film. To find this template and more, check out the link in this. Never mind. Let's talk about one of my personal favorite platforms, YouTube. I love it, I create videos for it all the time, and I have even before getting this job at Viddyoze, I spend a lot of my time watching YouTube videos and making YouTube videos. So really, it's kind of sad. I spend a lot of my time on YouTube, as do around 2 billion other people during a month, I think it is. Yeah, 2 billion active people on it a month. So, you know, it's not really a place you want to miss out being on. present wise content. Wow, what am I saying? So you have a YouTube channel and you are pushing out regular content, or let's say you've always really, really wanted to make one, but you are a perfectionist and you can't handle that homemade look. Something that can take your videos to the next level are intros and outros. Look at any YouTubers you like watching, they'll have an intro, they'll have a call to action at the end, or any series you like watching on YouTube, there's always an intro and an outro. And you might be thinking, oh, well, they have the animation know-how, you know? Maya, you know, you can edit videos, I'm sure you can make animations. No. A lot of people end up outsourcing, spending a lot of money on animators, or, you know, going on Fiverr and ending up with a really crappy one. But you can cut through all of that and make it all yourself on videos. You can literally, in a few clicks, add your own logo, colors, whatever. You can have the intro, can be your logo with a live action animation like this. Your outro can be any of our call to actions, and it's literally just so quick and it will step up your video game just like that. Oh, whoops. Hi. No. Oops. Hi, I'm done. I like to pretend that. Hi, I'm Dan. I like to film things from cupboards and pretend like I didn't know the camera was there. Okay, the most exciting thing that's gonna happen to me today is about to happen, so you're coming with me. Oh, that's zoomed in. Obviously, we are working from home, so life's kind of the same day every day, because you just kind of wake up, do workout, home. We don't have any weights or anything because all the shops were like sold out. So we just do a workout at home and my stomach's heavy. And then work. This lens is so zoomed in, all you can see is my head. So the highlights of my day are the delivery man. sounds bad. Oh my god, is there two? Are these both mine? Nope, they're not. Yes! Package! Oh my god, this door. Why are these doors so heavy? The package is secured. This is a real skill, this. I need to put this on my CV. Filming myself. Am I? The electrician seems to have removed everything from our cupboard because he's taking the fuse box. There's a fuse box? Electric box? The mains. Mains box out and putting a new one in. But no one told us that that was happening today, so we have no electricity. No heating. Luckily our laptops are charged and I'm filming, but yeah, we have no heating and it's absolutely freezing, like it's so cold. Why is it when I film a video, does it have to be about something bad happening? Why can't I just film a video and like, something good happened? Maya won the lottery. When's that video come in? Just going on my walk, lunchtime walk. Am I even in focus? Oh my god, I'm not. That whole thing. Oh my god, I have to film it again. Where's Jack? Jack? Jack! Jack! He's got the sound thing. You can't be away from me. They know. They connect to each other. You can't be away. It's just, oh my god, he's holding the sound thing. You've just gone over there. Oh my god. So I'm just on my afternoon lunchtime walk. Who am I kidding? I came out to literally just have something other than sitting inside the house to film, because that would just make for a really boring vlog, you know, you just sat around the house. But that's like literally what I'm doing. It's absolutely freezing. Oh my god, I'm not in Bali anymore. Anyway, I'm going to bear the cold to talk about Twitter, because Twitter, like the cold, you either love it or you hate it, but you don't want to miss out on using it because it's still a great medium to make short and snappy messages to send to potential customers or your clients or whatever. It's a short, snappy, to the point platform that allows you to be a little bit witty as well. Like that's the thing that Twitter has that a lot of other platforms don't, that you can show a bit of your personality, be a bit witty, a bit funny. This is not the angle for me. Twitter is literally the home of GIFs. Like it's king of GIF. Everyone loves a GIF. Is it a GIF or a GIF? It's a GIF, isn't it? GIF. Everyone loves a GIF on Twitter. So did you know that with Template Club, you can actually export your animations as GIFs? So it's perfect to create them and then be able to post them on Twitter and share your new release or a funny tweet or a promotion or anything using a GIF on Twitter. You don't want to be missing out on it. I was going to film the rest of this outside, but no, it's honestly too cold. I'm not doing it. So just welcome to this video of me basically showing you around different rooms, small frames of it, of my new place. Now we're in the kitchen, fun. Okay, so for my fourth area / platform, we're gonna delve into the world of ads. Now the world of ads is definitely a big one up for debate, whether they are worth it or not. And Dan actually talks about video marketing in a few of our Real Gold episodes. We have a weekly series on our YouTube channel, which I'll link down below. Definitely check that out and subscribe so you don't miss the next episode. There's no denying the potential reach of using paid ads on Facebook. And in the current algorithm versus creator world, you have the upper hand in using them. So you better make them eye-catching, otherwise it's just money down the drain. Since Facebook and Instagram have had their union, it is now easier than ever to link them both and check your ads insights and to schedule posts and be able to run things across both platforms. But what's really important is you have to break through those videos of those amazingly heroic parents saving their children or really cute cats. How do you break through that? Like, no, you can do it, you can do it. You need really eye-catching, short, snappy animations. The key is to keep things short. When it's an ad, no one wants to sit there and watch a 5-minute ad. It needs to be short, snappy. They wanna get back to those cat videos, but if you're gonna hold their attention in between those swipes, it needs to be short, snappy, and it needs to be like, wow. It needs to blow your mind. How it looks is going to up anything you have to say, because everything on social media these days is visual. It's just the way it is, it's visual. So you need to be stepping it up. Live action animations are a great example because people see it and they're kind of like, ah, that's really cool. How did they do that? I need to stop doing that. I can't actually click my fingers. Anyway, next. I'm gonna end this with a TikTok dance. I'm kidding, I'm not doing a TikTok dance. Ignore the background. This room is not set yet. These prints like came with the place. Well, we have actually ordered all new prints to go up on the walls, all new frames. So we've got the prints, we're just waiting for the frames. We got them off Decenio and it's gonna just look completely different. I left my phone in here, which has my notes. Because key to successful videos, guys, is not knowing where your phone is. Key to successful videos is preparation. Fail to prepare, prepare to fail. So anyway, what am I saying? So my final area I'm gonna talk about is to people who aren't looking to share products, services, or anything like that on social media right now or ever, or I don't know. And instead talking to your staff, your clients in a more internal way is what you're looking to do. Animations are still key in helping you deliver successful, engaging, and good content to speak to staff. How many corporate videos have you watched when you've worked in a shop or whatever? I know I've worked in retail before and you watch the corporate video and it's the CEO, and they just sit there and they talk about how amazing this year's been for about 20 minutes. And I'm sorry, it's boring, let's be honest. They can be really boring. And the purpose of a company video is to inspire and to rally up company morale. So you want to be engaging all of those team members and staff as well as possible. And animations can help you do that. It is a proven technique in film to help keep the viewer engaged. Think about all the Netflix shows you've watched, the documentaries where they could just have someone sitting and talking about the latest conspiracy theory for 5 hours, but instead they illustrate it in really cool animations. Everything that the person is saying, they illustrate with animations. And how much more engaging is that than just hearing me right now talk about this? These can so easily be added on to any company video you're making and then be unlistedly added. So like added to YouTube, but unlisted. that makes sense, so that no one can see it without having a link, so that it's private and it's not going out to everyone. Or if you have a staff intranet, you can upload it to your staff intranet. And I think it is really important to have those staff channels, especially in a world right now where we are so far away from each other and everyone is working remotely. Like, I haven't properly met a lot of my team members, and I'm not going to be able to see them for a very long time. So having that separate area which is not just outward facing is for the team is really important, and you want to be making sure the content on there has as much effort put into it as your external staff, because you know your staff are the ones that keep things going. Hint, hint. Anyway guys, that is it from me. I hope you enjoyed this vlog and me talking through these points. If you did, please do give it a like and make sure you subscribe so we can see you here again, and I will see you all in the next one.